Hey guys! Today I'm going to be showing you the 5 things I did wrong when I started composting and the one thing that I'm doing now that is making my composting so much easier. So, let's get started! So guys, I've been trying to compost ever since we moved in to the new house and it was great when I first started it. I was like super excited, but over the last 2 years I have like really failed to get the compost to work. It has become an eyesore and it has taken up so much space at the back of the house, and I wish I had known these things before I started. That's why I'm gonna be sharing them with you today. So the first thing that I have learned through trying to compost is don't start without a plan, okay? Don't try and wing it. I just thought I would do YouTube, like a DIY thing, and like do it on my own, but I didn't really know what I was doing. And so I'll take you outside and show you what we had going on at the back.
So this is the original compost bin I threw together when we first moved into the house. And you come up to it, basically I just took an old bin that was here when we moved in and I drilled holes into it. But it's just like, it was so heavy and it was just, I couldn't get in there and turn it or anything. And it just got too much, like I couldn't get it to like work properly, and it wasn't really composting down very fast.
So the second thing is that I took on too much at once. I tried to just throw the dirt in there and throw food in there and I thought that it would just work, but there is a system and there's kind of like a way to compost properly. I didn't really know how to do it. I would just chuck all the food scraps that we had in each week and I would just throw some dirt in there, some sticks and some leaves, and I was just hoping that it would work. But it didn't really work, and what I've learned is that you have to only put little bits at a time, and there are certain foods that work better at the start and certain foods that aren't good, and then once you kind of get it started, then it can really work for you. So yeah, don't do too much at once. The third thing I learned is making sure you're able to actually turn the soil. So with the one I had at the back in the bin, it was so big that I wasn't able to turn it. I didn't actually have anything to turn it. When I did try to turn it, I used a shovel to try to get in there and it just really wasn't effective and I couldn't get all the way to the bottom. And that's why when I tried to do it, it just like wasn't working and just smelled and was gross and wasn't breaking down the food.
At the back of our place, I decided to make a giant compost with the intention of making a big one and then rotating it and sifting it down and down and down the line. But I haven't touched this all year and now it looks like this. It's just full of weeds. So this is the original thing. So I took some of the produce from the other buckets and put it in here, mixed it with topsoil, and then I was adding all my scraps in here, trying to rotate it and trying to then eventually move it to like the next one and then sift it and then move it to the next one. But I mean, you can tell like all the animals have gotten to here, like chipmunks and maybe even mice and squirrels have all gotten here and kind of like made holes in it.
The fourth thing is trying to keep the animals out. So when I moved out to the back, which you'll see when I made the giant one out the back, it became a huge problem keeping the animals out because it was, you know, just open. All the chipmunks and squirrels and mice or whatever have gotten into it and made it their home instead of my, you know, composting home. And so that's really bad. You don't want those animals like inside of your compost. So that was a huge problem. And the fifth thing is an eyesore. So the one at the back is just so ugly. The weeds are all in it. It's just like, just really, people don't have that space in their house. Like we have a big yard. I could do that. But not people, people don't have that giant space. And it just looks bad. And so what I've done, what I've figured out along the way is that we had the guys from Sub Pod reach out to us to help with me doing my compost from home. And I'm so excited to be using their Sub Pod because it has been amazing in helping me compost more effectively. So the Sub Pod was super easy to put together. It came together in just a few minutes. And then it also comes with this really nice, you know, stainless steel like box that you can put in. And what happens is because it's in that planter, when you put the Sub Pod into it, it actually covers up all the holes so animals can't get into it. And the lid locks nice and tight so no animals can get into it. And it looks really nice, And the way that it's designed is that they teach you, the subpod teach you how to actually compost properly. Under the lid, they have step-by-step instructions that show you how to do it, what to do first, how to get the worms, which side to put it in, how to rotate it, and also comes with this really cool twirly aerator thing, which enables you to actually aerate. That's something that I didn't have before. I wasn't able to aerate the soil effectively, which just made everything kind of like bogged down, start to smell and kind of like rot instead of composting. So that tool is really, really cool and has really, really helped get my compost going. That's right. So guys, if you want to check out the sub pod, there's going to be a link in the description box below. Go check it out. If you want to start composting, I highly recommend getting yourself a sub pod. It's going to save you so much time. And you know, you're not going to be wasting time. You're not going to be wasting time trying to do it on your own and just have like a giant bin full of rotting soil. And so, what do you want to tell them, Soph?
About the food.
Yeah?
Catchings.
You want to say, click the link below.
Catching food. Dice.
Yeah?
Your mom's shoes.
Oh, they're your shoes, yeah. You gonna say compost?
And Mars.
What?
But
say hi guys.
Hi guys.
Yay! Yeah.
No, wash your hands.
Yeah.
Oh, wash your hands.
Oh, wash your hands. There you go, everyone. Wash your hands. Okay. Say bye, guys.
Bye.